Girls grow strong giving back to their communities. You all do a lot of projects, right?
Yeah.
Sometimes you help out at senior activities, sometimes you help out at recreation activities,
yeah.
And that's very helpful to all the people that whatever group you help. Whereas Girl Scouting takes an active role in increasing girls' awareness of opportunities available to them today in the fields of math, science, sports, technology, and other professional fields that can expand their horizons. Who likes math? Raise your hand. Dave's a little quicker than math. I don't know. Who likes science? Raise your hand.
Who doesn't care?
Who likes sports? Throw your hands down. Who likes sports? Whereas the Girl Scouts part of New Jersey, that's a special program, Girl Scouts part of New Jersey?
That's a council from Delaware Water Gap to Hudson River. That's okay. The area we serve.
Whereas the Girl Scouts part of New Jersey was formed in 2008 and capably delivered the optimal Girl Scout experience to over 28,000, that's another big group, young women and adults in Essex, Hudson, Huntington, Middlesex, Somerset, Union, and Warren counties. That's all part of New Jersey, okay? That's all part of New Jersey. Whereas more than 3.8 million Girl Scouts nationwide, including in excess of 100,000 in the state of New Jersey, joined in celebrating and rejoicing in this great American tradition, and nearly 50 million who are former Girl Scouts and living proof of the impact of this amazing movement. Now, therefore, I, Richard F. Turner, Mayor of the Township of Weehawken, on behalf of the Township Council, who hereby applaud and compliment Girl Scouting, has made to support the leadership development of America's girls, and proudly proclaim the week of March 6th to 12th as Girl Scout Week in Weehawken, New Jersey. And that's your proclamation. Now, single those guys who want. They are members of the first aid squad. And whenever you have an emergency at home, they come and help you. And some of them volunteer, some of them get paid, most of them volunteer their time, okay? And so it's very important, because when you're sick at home, or your mommy or your daddy or somebody, they're the ones that show up and need help. And if you need them, you call. What number do we tell them to call? You tell them, what number do you call?
911.
Very good. That's what people call 911, and you say you give your address and you say you need an ambulance, okay? All right, so let's get the first aid squad.
Did you want your picture? Oh, you're trying to take your sister's bag. Last but not least, the role.
Erica is also, what, in the National Guard? And what's your, what are you doing? She's a PFC in the National Guard of the Discovery. That's our first term. Then we have Lauren Keith's eighth consecutive term as Secretary Treasurer. Lauren, come on up. Eve Sod, fourth consecutive term as Second Lieutenant. Travels every day from Pennsylvania, right? Where?
Warren County.
Well, Warren County's next to Pennsylvania. He wants to the Delaware River. He's a Delaware River guy. Numargo Vasquez, 10th consecutive term as second lieutenant. And Numargo runs the annual golf fundraiser every year. It's coming. What's it, when are we doing it?
Early August.
It's coming up sometime in August. Is he here? Maybe. Julie, you married?
Yes.
Brian. Julie and Brian Murray, 13th and second term, first and 10th. Also, he's very busy. He's also a member of the Detective Bureau. And he's also a member of the school board. And he's also about to be a newlywed pretty soon. We warned him, but because he was saying, really? So Giovanni Daniel Ahmad is for the 10th consecutive term as the captain of the squad. Gio? Thomas Chetwick, who is, actually, I don't know if he finds his spare time, his 16th consecutive term as vice president, and he has like 15 kids or something. And his first one. Now, this is a milestone also. And he's, was there in the beginning, he's there now, and this whole team here holds the first aid squad together for the 36th consecutive term, our Director of Public Safety, Jeff Wells, as President of the squad. And Noel Wells is very happy that Jeff does this for 36 years, because he's not home then. Now I'm going to swear you guys in. I'm going to go down there so people can see you. Now we have a lot of people in the room, so nothing. We do this every year. Sometimes they get a little snarky, so we're going to be very good tonight in front of all the children. So raise your right hand. You'll do it right. I'm going to say aye, I'm going to state your name, ready? I
state your name.
Now, I, give me a bit of a go ahead, I, do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
To uphold the office of.
To uphold the office of.
Say, name your office.
Mayor.
Name your office.
President.
Of the Weehawken Volunteer First Aid Squad.
Of the Weehawken Volunteer First Aid Squad.
I furthermore pledge. To uphold the bylaws and rules.
To uphold the bylaws and rules.
And regulations.
And regulations.
Of the squad.
Of the squad.
To faithfully, I hate this part. I usually say something fresh. To faithfully be good, execute.
Faithfully execute.
Can you sit there? The duties on my office.
The duties on my office.
Serve the citizens of Weehawken.
Serve the citizens of Weehawken.
The mayor of Weehawken.
And the mayor.
And the mayor.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. Albany, from Black Creek. She has a new project, by the way.
Thank you.
Okay. Councilman Sosa has asked you to excuse his mother, fell in spring ankle. So we're going to excuse Councilman Sosa.
Thank you very much. Good evening, all. Hope your lungs are okay. Thank you very much, and I will express your sentiments. She will be. She wants to go back to work.
90 years old, nothing. How old? 90 years old, nothing stops.
She's 91.
91, nothing stops.
All right. Well, plus, chapter.
Okay. Hold on, speaking statement, please.
An honest time, applied for a public meeting as president satisfied. The notice of this meeting is published in the annual notice of the adopted by the Township Council on December 9, 2015. Said resolution is presented by the Township Clerk, and the notice is posted in the Township Hall.
Okay. Great communication by the board now. Citizens' comments on the agenda. Does anyone care to comment on any item on the agenda? Okay. We're going to go down to the agenda. Actually, we're on for a few business. Rooming house hearings. Tonight's our annual rooming house hearings. Is that Wells? Is that Wells? Tell me loud.
Yes.
We're doing our rooming house hearings. So we will call up the applicant. We'll call up the inspectors. I'm not sure who all the inspectors are. Sean, you're doing housing?
Yes.
And fire?
Yes.
You're going to have to come up and be sworn in when we call you up, okay? And you're going to do this, right? All right, so first is 1850 Street. Jesus Rodriguez. Jesus, if you come up, please.
Testimony about the giving of the truth and all truth.
I do.
Your name, please?
Yes,
questions?
No, no question.
Okay. Mr. Mara, Detective Mara.
The only thing that I had at 850 Street, there was a, looks like it was a tenant dispute, and based on the reports, it looks like she has since moved, probably about 5 calls over the course of 6 months.
I'm sorry?
About 6 calls over the course of 6 months, basically just dispute with the tenant, apparently some eviction proceedings, and now she has.
With a tenant, another tenant, or a tenant, Mr. Rodriguez?
Tenant, that was said.
Okay, so Mr. Rodriguez? Come to the court. So you had a dispute with the tenant, that's all been resolved?
I couldn't.
Okay, so she's no longer a tenant?
No.
All right, that was the only incident? Any questions with the council? Okay, thank you very much. That's the only incident that you said, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right, Mr. Rodriguez, do you have any questions with us?
No questions.
All right, do I have a motion to approve the rooming license? There's no additional questions for 1850 Street?
So moved.
I'll second.
Moved by Councilman Chakoni, second, Councilman Martino, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilman Mastriano?
Yes.
Councilman Martino?
Yes.
Councilman Chakoni?
Yes.
Mayor Turner?
Yes. You're good for another year, thank you. You're very nice. Thank you.
Good night.
Okay, next will be Yvonne Arcaro, 1748 Street. Yvonne, for the record, give your name and address, please.
Yvonne Arcaro.
Address?
Thank
you, sworn, please.
You raise your hand, please. You swear the testimony that you will be the truth, no truth?
Okay. Madam Clerk, do you have an application for 1748 Street?
Yes.
And your findings?
Okay.
Mr. Venino?
Thank you, Your Honor.
Okay. Want to sit aside? Sit in, please. Okay. Mr. Masterson, if you want to follow, you're under oath. Have you had the opportunity to review 1748 Street for housing?
Yes.
And your findings?
No violations, no.
Any questions of Mr. Masterson? He found out no violation. Okay, thank you. Mr. Gorman, Captain Gorman. Do you have the opportunity to review 1748 Street?
Yes, 1748 Street was inspected by Inspector Gold on John 11 and found no violations.
Okay, any questions of Captain Dorman?
Is that the final one?
Yes.
Yes, I do have one question. We went to quite a lot of expense to put in the fire extinguishers, and I had all new ones that were there only maybe 3 years, and then we were told to take them out. Why?
Who told you to take them out?
Well, they told my son told me. I just didn't know.
Do you know
who told your son?
Who told you?
It wasn't that they were told not to take them out. They just said that they were not needed, and they could be more of a hazard if you're not equipped to know how to handle them.
Were they a special type of extinguisher?
Regular fire extinguisher.
Do you know who?
I don't remember. It was many years ago.
Do you have a kitchen?
Oh, it was many years ago?
You have a kitchen premises, it was an extinguisher.
No.
How many years ago, about?
We took them about 3 or 4 years ago.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what.
If they don't happen, there's no violation, there's no code of civil.
Okay, so what we'll do, since you brought up and there seems to be confusion, we will have Mr. Dorman or Mr. Pearl to contact you or your son and straighten it out, okay?
Yes,
all right, so we get, it happened several years ago, so it's going to be hard to say who the inspector was. But it was a fire official, you think?
I think so.
Okay, all right, well, Mr. Dorman, Mr. Pearl will reach out to you and figure out where we are.
Mr. Pearl was on vacation right now, he does the inspection over here. I'll have to talk to him and see what
it is. Okay, when he goes back, it's been going on for 2 or 3 years, so it won't make any difference, okay? But Mr. Don Raphael Peralta, he will get a hold of you, okay? Or your son.
Other than that, I don't know.
Okay, very good. Where am I, sir? Sergeant Matt. I have just had an opportunity to look at the records of 748 Street.
Yes, sir. Just one moment. My name was found in the resident area without a hanger.
Okay, so that's not really, like, do you have any questions out of Detective Sergeant? Okay. Questions for the council? Mr. O'Carroll, do you have any questions at all?
No, sir.
All right, hearing none, I have a motion to approve the renewal license for 748 Street.
So moved.
Move Councilman Zaccone.
Second.
Second, Councilman Silvestri. Roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilman Silvestri.
Yes.
Councilman Almarino, yes. Councilman Zaccone.
Yes.
Mayor Trigger.
Yes. Okay, thank you very much. You're renewed. You're welcome to stay. You're welcome to leave, whatever you want.
Thank you.
Okay, Madam, thank you. Good seeing you again. You run a very nice place also.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Castrosas, would you like to come forward?
Evening.
And I'm fishing, huh?
No, please don't.
Would you go?
Absolutely.
I'm good for you. Okay, will you be sworn, please?
Raise your hand. You swear testimony about the truth, the whole truth?
Yes.
Okay, Madam Clerk, do you have an application for 2949 Street?
Yes.
And you find me?
Okay.
Mr. Menino?
Stay here.
Okay, sit aside, please. Just pass the call, please, just on the road. Have you had the opportunity to inspect 2949 Street?
Yes.
And your findings?
There was no violations found.
Okay, any questions, Mr. Castrosas? Okay, Mr. Captain Gordon, just on the road. Have you had the opportunity or just a call to inspect 2949 Street?
Yes, inspected, called inspected on January 11, 2016 also, and found no violations.
Any questions?
No.
Okay, Mr. Eric? Just on the road. You got the opportunity to inspect 2949 Street?
Yes, inspected on March 2nd of the year and without a letter.
Okay, thank you very much. Any questions? Detective Sergeant Barrett, have you had the opportunity to correct 2949 Street?
Yes, sir.
And your findings?
A couple of medical calls on one
for new firearms range use agreement. We're switching from Woodridge to North Bergen, it's closer. And as you all know, the Attorney General's Office requires twice a year of firearms training, so it says a lot of running back and forth. Every officer has to be trained or go for qualification twice a year.
Right, where is that located? It's on West Side Avenue. They have a piece of parcel that North Bergen owns. And besides the closeness, it's several thousand dollars cheaper than what we're paying Woodridge.
Next draw, we have a motion.
So moved, second.
Where the beaches, moved Sylvester, second, Lamarino, roll call.
Councilman Sylvester Gary?
Yes.
Councilman Lamarino?
Yes.
Councilman Spohy?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Director Wells and Manager Ahmad and myself have had several meetings starting last week with various police organizations, New Jersey Transit, for preparations if there is indeed a rail strike, New Jersey rail strike, which would commence 12:01 Monday morning or Sunday.
Well, it's Sunday night, yeah. Well, actually Saturday night, I guess.
Oh, it'd be Saturday night, would it be Sunday?
Yeah, it's Sunday morning.
Okay. So would you like to give, we have a meeting with elected officials and various emergency management personnel and police departments from all over. It's an amazing grouping of police departments. You have all over police departments, North Bergen, Weehawken, West New York, Duckburg, Seat Marcus, Hoboken, Jersey City, Bayonne, Union City. You have the transit police, you have the county sheriff's office, you have Port Authority police, and you have state police. And so there was a meeting yesterday with Hudson County. Today there was a meeting with the Port Authority with all their facilities, correct?
That's correct.
And we're all trying to coordinate in case the situation deteriorates. So I have you have just gave me a critical service advisor, so why don't you give us an update?
As the mayor said, there's a potential shutdown of heavy rail, which is the trains that New Jersey Transit runs. It doesn't affect the light rail, it doesn't affect the bus operations, separate unions. The problem is that every day, approximately 100,000 people take New Jersey Transit, most of them to New York City, some to Penn Station and Newark.
The rail service.
The rail service. Port Authority's contingency, Transit's contingency plan is to do parking rides in five locations throughout the state. Some of them will be going through the Lincoln Tunnel to the bus terminal, some of them will be going to the Penn Station in Harrison, some of them will be going to the Penn Station in Newark. However, the Ramsey train station, which is on Route 17 at the New York border, has over 900 car spaces. Those people are going to be bused from Ramsey to Lincoln Harbor Ferry. What everyone realizes that waterway ferries, both in Puerto Rico and Lincoln Harbor, run at half capacity. It's the only system that has capacity to take additional people. Path is maxed out. The special bus lane that the Port Authority and the Tunnel XPL is maxed out. So the Ramsey train station people will be bused to Lincoln Harbor in Weehawken, and then an enhanced bus service along River Road from Fort Lee to Weehawken will terminate at the Port Imperial Station ferry because of the capacity and ability of the ferry to take hundreds of more passengers than they do now. Obviously, the bus terminal in New York can't handle the amount of buses that would be necessary. If the strike takes place, the bus lane at the Lincoln Tunnel will be opening at 5 in the morning instead of 6 and continue to 10 o'clock instead of 9 o'clock, based on volume. The biggest problem we have is their contingency plan provides accommodation for 40,000 of their 100,000 passengers. So 60,000 people basically have to find another way to go to work. And that's the concern. If they open passenger cars, we're going to be overwhelmed at all the transits across, and not just the Lincoln Tunnel and the ferry station. All right. Late today, there was a good sign the union leadership announced that as long as they're making progress, they'll delay the strike, at least day to day. So it may not take effect. Today, good progress was made. They're meeting again tomorrow, hopefully the strike. But if there is a strike, we are going to have a very serious traffic condition because of our ferry locations and people that are driving in. Driving in trying to get to the ferry. The parking garages on the waterfront will be filled very rapidly, and then anyone that gets there will be wandering around looking for space. We've had assistance from transit police, Port Authority police. We're going to be beefing up our own Weehawken police in case of a strike to make sure that we don't have gridlock so that we can provide services, police, fire, EMS, to the citizen. As you all know, 495 splits the town in half. We've got to make sure those intersections are open. Not just us, you know, the city of Manistack is very concerned about the same issues in Mount Vernon. Hopefully the strike will be settled, but if not, you know, we're going to have a very serious traffic problem. Maybe not the first day, because everyone thinks people are going to take vacation. But day two, day three of the strike, when they realize the bus can't accommodate, we may have a lot of additional vehicle traffic. And where do they go?
So, we find this very hard to believe, but New Jersey Transit is predicting that there could be as many, not just in our area, but northern portions, all the transit portions, as many as 10,000 additional cars per peak rush hour. We find that very hard to believe. So, as a result of all the meetings, we've been in contact with the governor's office, we've contact with DOT, Mayor Stack, myself, the other mayors, because obviously we are going to make sure that all main routes remain open. It'll be an additional expense. We'll be coordinating, like I said, with the Port Authority, with the Sheriff's Department, to the extent that everybody's personnel can be stretched, or as far as they can be stretched. We've made the point that we have to keep the roads open for emergency vehicles, for school buses, and whatever. And you know what? Commuters will take any road they can to get close to the top. So the good news is today they're still negotiating, but preparations still have to go underway. And we will hold the Sunday shift over for Monday morning just in case, unless we hear word sometime on Sunday night. Sometimes it comes down until late at night, the last minute, and that may be resolved. Mayor Stack and myself have also requested to stay with the free person for any costs, as soon as those chances may be. But we've made the point, we've also made the point that under no circumstances will we allow our communities, since 495 divides North Bergen, Weehawken, and New York City's half, we will not allow our communities to be completely gridlocked. Hoboken has a particular problem, because the same thing applies on their south of the Holland Town and on the north of the So, have they set up a command center yet, just in case?
Port Authority is going to have a command center linking for the 495 corridor. Transit still in the process of having a fixed location. The mobile command post can't handle the amount of representatives that are affected.
Where's that?
Port Authority Lincoln Tunnel is going to have a
command center. They can't handle
it all. Yeah, because remember, Lincoln Tunnel Command Center has cameras on the entire 495 corridor.
That's where they're going to be.
The mobile command, the transit, the buses, the mobile command, the buses, you can't handle the amount of people that need it, so they're trying to get a fixed location.
So, starting tomorrow, we will be posting notices and giving advisories to the residents. We're waiting until tomorrow, we're going to find the police updates and find out how the progress goes. We're also seeing if we can, our residents will have a problem. They go to Manhattan if the traffic backs up. So we're going to see if we can do anything with our own shuttle buses in the morning and evening to pick up people and bring them down to the light rail station with the ferry terminal, which will be jammed also, but at least we'll make an attempt. But we're encouraging people, whether if there is a strike for the first day, to see if they can stay home, work from home, and avoid any confusion. But we will keep the roads open. We will let the school buses, ambulances, police, and fire trucks will get through. And we'll coordinate this with North Bergen and Union City on our end. We will coordinate with Hoboken on their end. Obviously, Hoboken has a major hospital. Palisade Hospital is a major hospital in our area, and we want to make sure we have access to those points also. Questions of the director?
I know this is not within our purview, but is there any mandate that single occupancy cars cannot go through these any of the tunnels, bridges, et cetera?
It's one of the things they're looking at, the logistics of doing that, where they do it, would have a significant impact on Weehawken.
Yeah.
All right. Port Authority is also looking about potential of a second special bus lane of one to three eastbound lanes. Because right now the XBL, the special town flow bus, is at capacity.
Yeah.
They're adding another 100 buses per hour to that XBL. So that's one of the things they're looking at. For Weehawken, we would prefer that than the HOV, because the problem is, where do you turn people away?
Right.
And that this
puts around there. We're all encouraging people to use common sense and not come up on city cars, but once they get there, it's possible to turn around. So that has been brought up, and it's also been brought up if in case we have to ask the state to declare a state of emergency for Hudson County in general, since we have two major crossings. Okay, any other questions? All right, we have two more resolutions, and we're going to go into executive session. While you're here, Director, we have resolution authorizing the purchase of four police cars. I think they're, are they all SUVs?
Three are SUV, one is a utility van, that's what our serve of the Technical Bureau, our awesome investigation, and our accident investigation unit.
There are four different resolutions, because there are vehicles and equipment. One is replacement, I believe, and something.
Right, we have
that's for the accident.
Accident. We've been
insurance reimbursement.
We've been paid by the insurance company for the vehicle.
Okay. So you want this one vote or four seven?
Quite good part, second.
Okay, so we have four resolutions for the police cars. One is a model year 2016 Ford Highview Transit 350 police vehicle. I have no idea what that is. What is
that's
it?
That's like a utility van.
It's a utility van.
Yeah.
That's a 350.
We're going to consolidate our Austin, our accident, and our crime scene investigation.
This also includes optional public safety emergency equipment. The next is two resolutions. This says two new models.
Yeah, that this resolution has two police vehicles. This is equipment. This is certificate of availability of funds that applies to all.
Okay, so the next is two model 2016 police vehicles. Police interceptor utility. Is that SUV?
That's an SUV. State contract Ford Explorer.
We've changed all SUVs now because since Superstorm Sandy. We've learned that the higher the car is and the more four-wheel drive people with snowstorms and all SUVs work better than just a regular police car. So I think eventually we'll have all.
Yeah, I mean they're only like less than $1,000 cheaper, more expensive than a traditional sedan, and we have so much more.
The next resolution is equipment for the two Ford utility interceptor police vehicles, lights and sirens and whistles and all. And the last one is one police utility, another police
interceptor
utility.
Okay. We're getting three. That's replaced. Yeah, replaced the one.
We had an accident with a police car and the insurance company reimburses $18,000 for the week.
They totaled the vehicle, yeah.
So do I have a Mr. Zucconi? I think you jump into this.
We have to do that.
As a former prosecutor and director, I mean, deputy director. So Councilman Zucconi moves the police package. Second by Councilman Lapino, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilman Sestriere?
Yes.
Councilman
Lomino?
Yes.
Councilman
Sponi?
Yes.
Mayor
Kerner?
Yes. And the last resolution, this year, fiscal year, which ends June 3rd, we're donating $50,000 to the first aid squad for the new ambulance. And this is contract will go for the second donation and goes down to 11.
This can cover
everything. Okay. So we're making one $50,000 contribution. For this fiscal year, it's not July 1, make another $50,000, and then you'll match that with your $40,000 of money that you raised. So, we can move that resolution. Move Councilman Lamanino.
Second.
Councilman Speciere, roll call.
Councilman Speciere?
Yes.
Councilman Lamanino?
Yes.
Councilman Zucconi?
Yes.
Mayor Kerner?
Yes. All right. Approving the bills?
That one.
Lamanino?
Second.
And then also?
Yes.
Second. Councilman Zucconi, roll call the bills.
Councilman Speciere?
Yes.
Councilman Lomino?
Yes.
Councilman Zucconi?
Yes.
Mayor Kerner?
Yes. For personnel, you should stay for some day on the settlement of the one officer. You should stay for personnel for 1 minute. Approves of the floor, I have to address the council.
Yeah. I'll wait till next time. You guys had a long night.
So. Okay, thank you. Okay, hearing none, we'll close the public session. session, and I have a motion to go into executive session for litigation and personnel.
Will we be dispensed with regular order of business and reconvene as executive session?
Move by Sertoni.
Second.
Second by Sertor. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
All right, we'll go into executive session. Thank you all. You two stay. Thank you.
entrance.
The front entrance. Without contracts, the necessary repairs will remain open during construction, and after hours, park residents will still be available however you receive. However, you must use disturbing and new entrance exit to all the staff members installed.
Yes, we close the front entrance just to be safe, so everyone does have to use the still inside entrance exit until the scaffolding is up.
Okay, so then, so you'll be hearing updates, you'll be notified with